Welcome back to my software journal. My name is Ronald, and today we're going to be talking about the six different types of software engineers. So let's get into it. All right, so let's get into it. Starting out, when I first started my career, I wish I really knew exactly what area that I really want to go in as a software engineer. First off, when I really started my software engineer career, I started doing a lot of backend stuff, dealing with building APIs and all this different other stuff. But I also was put into projects such as mobile development and web development. But I was really into focusing on, you know, backend type stuff and writing the logic and, you know, dealing with that particular technology. Yeah, I wish I would have knew when I first got into software engineering what area that I really want to go in. And today we're going to be talking about those different types of software engineers. And this is front-end engineers, back-end engineers, full-stack engineers, infrastructure DevOps engineers, security engineers, and also QA engineers. So I'm going to be touching on these different types of software engineers. So let's get into that. So front-end engineers. So the front-end engineers, you can think of as the people who deal with the user interface in which the users will actually interact with. So this is gonna be like the buttons, the banner, and anything that they will probably have to fill out or interact with an application. So best way they can explain that they deal with the visual aspects of the application. And that's pretty much what a front-end engineer. I actually did this here and there, but I really wasn't too back in engineering. I actually really didn't want to get into this early on, but I did really want to get into it now. I'm actually currently doing more front-end type stuff and getting more proficient in that particular area. All right, so number two, you have back-end engineers, and they deal with the logic and the data storage and handling for the application. So when you click that button, submit that form out, it does some stuff in the background to store it on the database. So they deal with the middle ground, also even building out the table schema for the database. So making sure you have the right relationships when you're working with the data. So whenever the user, you know, receives the information from the client side, they know exactly what schema that they need to call out for and what information they need to get. And a lot of that stuff is pretty much abstracted from the client side, and they just usually call from a endpoint, and that data just comes into like some type of JSON format. So that's essentially what backend engineers do. Let's get into number three, which is a full stack engineer. Full stack engineer is pretty much exactly what it is. It's a combination between front end engineers and also back end engineers. Yeah, they essentially, you know, build the front end aspects of the application and also deal with the back end aspects of it. And then you also have some full stack engineers that actually deal with the infrastructure of the system as well. So, you know, provisioning the server, provisioning the database servers, and also, you know, setting up that whole entire architecture. Those are just superhumans there. So, you know, look out for them. But yeah, essentially they deal with every single aspects of building the application from the front end and the back end. And yeah, they have a lot of knowledge and combined knowledge in order to do that. All right, so let's get into number four. So you have DevOps and infrastructure engineers. So they are the hardware for your software. Nowadays, when you're dealing with like AWS, Google Cloud Platform, and Azure, so when you're dealing with those particular platforms, they actually make it where, you know, infrastructure is code kind of thing. So I had this more experience with like AWS with their whole, what is it, cloud? Cloud Symphony? Dang, I can't even remember right now. I'm gonna look this up real quick. Ah, there it is. All right. With AWS, they have this thing called CloudFormation. Essentially, it's just a templating to provision servers. This template is just like in a JSON or a YML syntax format. And yeah, you'll, you know, put that template inside the system, click a button, and it will provision your whole entire system with the networking, the security system, the VPCs, and also the different, you know, servers that you want to provision for that system when you click that button. That's a really powerful system that a lot of people are getting into, especially in the government sector and especially military sector. and even private sector as well. So yeah, that's what I'm really trying to get into as well, only because it's just a really fascinating concept of just provisioning your system with a click out of button and, you know, have it there within, you know, seconds or minutes. Like I said, infrastructure engineers / DevOps, they essentially deal with like that building of the system, and they also deal with the continuous integration and continuous deployment of the software application on the system. They make sure that the developers can get their code out there and, you know, have these different environments to test their code and push this code for different environments until it gets to the final stage of the production. Now we're going to get into some more where I feel like a lot of people don't really talk about too much. Shoot, which one are we on right now? All right, number five, we have QA engineering, also called software QA engineers. Software QA engineers, they deal with the quality of the product. So you hear a lot of people with testers, test cases, test scripts, and all this other stuff. So usually in the back in the day, especially when dealing with software, you have to like manually look at each aspect of the feature of the software. But nowadays you have software QA engineers that have automation scripts, and they deal with making that whole manual process into an automation process. So they do a lot of verification on if this button is clicking properly, are these values showing properly when you submit that form, and, you know, everything is populating properly and everything is showing properly. I did a little bit of this, especially in the past, mainly when I was working with this, sent like multiple users, like fake users, to a system, and I use like JMeter in regards to that. So yeah, just, you know, testing the low performance on the system and see exactly where are the thresholds in regards to, you know, multiple users at a time. It was a pretty cool experience. And I also used Selenium as well for those web applications. I'm definitely going to be using this in applications that I build for myself. It's a skill that is so essential because you don't have to, when you're testing out your applications, you don't have to continuously, you know, do it by hand. If you got something like Selenium, you got something like JMeter in order to test out your performance or stress test out your distributed systems and make sure that everything is working properly and accordingly, then you have those tools that automate that process. To the last one that I feel like the reason why I really became a software engineer. And this last one is number six. Number six is security software engineers. Actually, software security engineers. I feel like this is a more up and coming type area in software engineering, especially nowadays where you have a lot of cybersecurity type stuff. Software security engineers, they usually deal with the vulnerabilities, looking at the vulnerabilities and monitoring the software application, also system. They continuously do investigations on what software patches need to be updated on a particular software and keeping track and also, you know, doing scans on the software and ensure that the right necessary dependencies are on the software and also on the system. So they deal with all the security, access, control of the system, ensuring that the system and everyone is upholding the guidelines of security and data. And they also deal with like penetration tests as well. And I have a lot of experience in dealing with this with like a lot of clients that I work with and also businesses that I work for professionally. And I feel like I really made a lot of major impact in this like space. I got a lot of recognition in regards to that. Because a lot of people might think, hey, why do I need to, you know, specify a specific exception on my catch block? And that's a security issue in regards to if there's an error on the system, then if your application grows infrastructurally big, especially in code architecture, then there's really no way to figure out where the main root cause of this problem. So this is one of the reasons why you make custom exceptions and all this other stuff. And yeah, just it gets really in depth. And like I said, it is something that's continuously coming up in this particular area of software engineering. So that's essentially the end of this video. Hopefully you guys got some value from that. If you got some value from that, make sure you do a like, comment down below, and subscribe to the channel. And also, until next time, peace.